Hey there, I'm Margarita, and if you don't know me, nobody cares, but I'm here to show you how fun and relatable science can be. So if you are interested, let's meet in the comment section and then you'll know me and still nobody will care, but I will be very, very happy and I will give you more content like that for ever and ever. I feel like you could perceive this as a threat, so it's not. Okay, so I read this study the other day which made me freak out in disgust because it did not comply with my views on my relationship, on the modern relationship in general, and I could not comprehend the findings or accept them. Yeah, that's the word. Accept the findings. The study is called Egalitarianism, Housework, and Sexual Frequency in Marriage. And it appeared in the American Sociological Review in 2013. Not 100 years ago, not 50, just 7. And in general, it states that couples who divided housework more equally had less sex than couples with traditional gender roles, you know, the woman cleaning, cooking, and having children, and the man being responsible for the income of the family, and maybe some manly task like fixing a shelf or something. What? You come and tell my boyfriend he should not do anything anymore in the household because it would make me want to have more sex and I'll give you a shelf to fix? Now that showed you. Well, either way, it made me go do some research on the topic, found the data they were working with, and while in my humble opinion it is very hard to state something based on questionnaires basically, because as you can imagine, I can tell you whatever I deem appropriate in the moment I'm being asked. But what else is there to do in such a study? I was kind of relieved to see that the findings were based on data from the 80s and 90s. Now go tell my dad he should not do anything in the household anymore to get mom more sexually attracted to him, and she'll give you an entire wardrobe to fix, I can tell you that. Okay, this is a thing now. But either way, the findings represent marriages that were formed before the relatively recent surge in dual earner families and egalitarianism being okay, not just okay, rather wished for in a relationship. So maybe, and I'm just saying this because I cannot force my view on older people and relationships because I haven't walked in their shoes, maybe it was just the way peer pressure and the social system forced you into roles, and if your partner helped you bloom in your role and thus have a socially accepted life in your community, it was more of a turn-on than being looked weirdly upon by others when being a stay-at-home dad, for example. Now, a more recent study from 2016 compared that data of the first study with data from couples up to 2006. They show how dramatically the picture has changed for couples in the past 2 decades. By 2006, couples who reported sharing the housework more or less equally had significantly more sex than couples where one person, usually the woman, did the major part of the chores around the house. So if you and your partner share the chores equally, are probably having more sex than couples who don't share the housework today, and even more than the traditional gender role couples from the study we talked about before. Here it is very important to note that sexual intercourse is generally declining worldwide in the past few decades, so we have less sex in general than the generations before us. Well, my first reaction to these news was what a pity, but on the other hand, I suspect that we're having less sex nowadays because, again, the gender roles do not force us into it. If I was a woman a few decades ago and I was married to someone to whom I'm obviously subordinate, not in the kinky kind of way though, and I feel like part of my chores is also to regularly please him sexually, then I'm fine with being a woman I am in the period of time I am. I can have as much or as little sex as I please myself with. Well, let's get back to the topic. Couples that share chores have more sex than everybody else. How come? Imagine you're in a relationship in which you feel unfairly treated, you feel you are doing everything on your own and don't get any help from your partner, instead just more clothes to wash, more dirt to clean, and more dinner to cook, you are probably not gonna be so satisfied in your relationship. You are probably pretty stressed and irritated all the time because let's not forget that you have school, jobs, and other things to do as well. You feel unfairly treated, so that's a turn off. And then you don't have sex, duh. If on the other hand, you have a partner who shares chores with you and relieves... No wait, I don't want to say relieve because it's not only the one's chores to start with. If both live in the same household, it's not his or her job that the other one is helping with. It's just as much her or his dirt and food and laundry. And now I'm getting into my feminist mind and again losing track of what I needed to say. Okay. If you don't feel exploited or unfairly treated in your relationship, you are obviously both gonna be more satisfied in it and can more easily do the eyebrow wink to each other. I'm so bad at this. Okay, so I'm gonna do some laundry and check where Patrick's at.